the first ever New Vision Education Expo that started on Friday, 27th January at the Uganda Institute of Information and Communication Technology, UICT, in Nakawa, has ended today. The expo was opened by the State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, and has since attracted thousands of participants that came to seek different services. Among the participants were parents, students, education stakeholders, institution heads, among others. State House Comptroller Jane Bareche was also present at the expo today. She inspected a number of stalls. Among them was the State House Industrial Hub tent, in which the youth were showcasing their skills in bridal makeup, metalworks and fabrication, carpentry, hairdressing, among other skills, which they obtained through the presidential initiative on skilling the youth. Bareche, together with the Vision Group Chief Executive Officer Don Wanyama, were driven in one of the tricycles fabricated by youth from the State House Industrial Hubs.
We invited many Ugandans to come and see what their country is capable of. Among other things that they exhibited, there is skilling Ugandans, which is under State House, where we are standing as of now. This is a program which the president started, and now it's 5 months old. We skill Ugandans, a youth from 18 years to 35 years of age. The selection is just age. We don't differentiate, don't discriminate them by educational background, by tribe, by anything apart from age group. So you come, use your hands, skill you, go and make money.
Bareche further urged Ugandans to embrace vocational skilling. She says the youth can join the State House Industrial Hubs spread across the country.
It's an opportunity to call all the Ugandans that are nearby or that have these hubs into their districts, please, into their greater regions, please come on board and support this program. The stakeholders, come and support your learners, come and support your children, sensitize them, bring the willing learners to come and learn the skills, go and get their families out of poverty.
Don Wanyama, the Chief Executive Officer of Vision Group, thanked State House for partnering with Vision Group to organize this expo. State House has been one of the main sponsors of the first New Vision Education Expo.
As Vision Group, we believe in advancing society by giving them content that really promotes society. And you cannot advance society if you don't pay attention to education and skills. And that is why we organized this expo. And I want to thank all the people who have come to this expo. It was the first time we were organizing this kind of expo. We've been overwhelmed by the attendance. But importantly, we want to thank State House for having taken the faith and joined us as sponsors.
Wanyama went ahead to hand over a certificate to the State House in appreciation for their participation in the Education Expo.
The State House stall, this one, has been one of the busiest. Which really shows the interest that Ugandans have. And we all know that ultimately what is going to make us grow as a society is vocational skills, and that is what we do. So I also want to join you in encouraging many Ugandans out there, our young people, the youth. You have now how many industrial hubs?
We have 19 in the country.
19. Find your way to one of these industrial hubs and get skills that are going to be very, very helpful.
Hundreds of youth from across the country have obtained vocational training through the State House industrial hubs, which are spread across the country. These gave testimonies on how their lives have been transformed through vocational training.
And join metal work, welding and metal fabrication. So after that, I did it very well. We came up with many things. As you, many people can see, we have come up with this motorcycle.
Today I'm doing a bridal exhibition. That is what I've done today at, you can see at the back. Yeah, that has been one of the services I love as a person. Because it helps. I love making people look good.
The New Vision Education Expo that concluded today was held under the theme Where Education and the World of Employment Meet. Over 100 institutions took part, and the main focus today was centered on how to make one's university degree count, early childhood education, and opportunities in vocational education. Report compiled by Rachel Nachuala for the news.